Welcome to Hypnosis Today, the nation's first Hypnosis TV talk show that explores the fascinating world of hypnotherapy. My name is Lisa Mackenberg, and I'll be your host. And we're going to explore so many ways people are using hypnosis today to achieve success, prosperity, and abundance. Today, I have two amazing guests. Well, my first guest is Todd Simon. He's an honors grad of HMI College of Hypnotherapy. He is the author of one of my favorite books. It's called A Little Infinity. And I love that title because it's a paradox wrapped in a conundrum. And they are pictures and inspirational sayings, and I use them, and I really love this book. Todd has with him his very special client, and his client's name is Davin. Davin came in to see Todd for sports performance. Please help me welcome my guests. Now, Davin, why a hypnotherapist for sports? Why not get some sort of a coach or something?
Well, I was a craniosacral client of Todd's for a couple of years. And then I learned of that he was studying hypnotherapy, and we were talking about the benefits of it. And I wound up having an experience on a field of second-guessing myself and experiencing fear and not playing very well. And so I talked to him about it, and he suggested that this might work.
Well, you had a little bit of a crisis of confidence out there on the field. Now, I love this, Todd, and let me tell you why. We need multiple streams of income. And you're a, give me the words again, a
cranial sacral therapist.
And that's a form of
osteopathy, the movement of bones in the body, specifically working with the cranium, all the sutures of the skull, and the sacrum, the very bottom of the spine.
That's what I was going to say.
Yes.
Yes. But in addition to this wonderful profession, you are also a hypnotherapist, and you actually combine the two. So you had this crisis of confidence. You're talking to Todd, and what do you do with someone who is a client both in hypnotherapy and
cranial sacral therapy?
Yes.
I let them know that I do combine the two. I let them, you know, I have to indoctrinate them into hypnotherapy. And so I do a traditional hypnotherapy session with them at first, and then the next session we do actually on the cranial sacral table. So when I induce the hypnotherapy, the second time I use progressive relaxation with a white light. And when I'm working with an athlete, I do specifically areas of the body that he needs to work on for his sport.
What area of the bodies do lacrosse players use?
The full body. And so I remember him working with me about my feet, quickness of feet, and also with my hands, and because you use a stick with both hands. And so you're moving a ball at high speeds, and you're running top speed. And so it's really upper body and lower body coordination that it involves.
Sure, so that is the whole body. I know what someone looks like when he or she goes into a hypnotic trance. When you're doing these kinds of osteopathic? Yes, manipulations. Do people go into an alpha or even a theta state?
They do. A lot of people do say they go into a dream state. They see images, colors, pictures.
So these things are very, very similar.
Absolutely. Their eyes go into catalepsy.
So you can use both inductions.
That's the beauty of it.
That is amazing. So what do you do next?
So with Davin, we figured out exactly why he was creating these stressful moments for him. We did some muscle testing with him as well in order to anchor some key words for him in order to have him be as confident as possible on the field.
I'm going to back up. What was causing some of these things, the second guessing yourself?
Ultimately, it was fear, but it was manifesting in the form of negative self-talk and second guessing myself. So an example of this was, I remember very clearly that someone was throwing a cross field pass to me, something that I would normally catch and move up the field. And as it was coming towards me in the air, I was second guessing myself and had the thought that I wouldn't catch it. And I missed it. And that kept happening, experiences like that throughout the game. And so I noticed it was all in my head, why I was having a bad game. And that's what we talked about.
Interesting, you said all in your head, and interesting that you manipulate the bones and muscles in the head. Wow, what a coincidence. So what can you do when someone is having this kind of a crisis?
So like I said, we did some muscle testing to find some
keys. What's muscle testing?
So muscle testing is basically based on the fact that the body, the nervous system, can't lie. So it'll show a weakness when there's incongruency in the body. So if I ask Dave in his name and he says Dave, and he'll be able to hold his arm pretty rigidly.
Can you show us some of this?
Sure.
After all, this is TV.
So I'll do what's called a baseline, where, David, if you could put your arm out and just resist my pushing. So I have a baseline of his strength. Now put your arm down for a moment. I'm going to ask you your name. You're going to give me your name, anything other than David. So put your arm back up. What's your name?
Todd.
So you'll see there's a weakness in the body. So the body's not able to hold a lie. And what we did is we found about four key phrases and words that he felt comfortable saying to himself during a game to kind of bring him into state. We muscle tested all four of them. The one that tested strongest in his body was get the ball.
Get the ball. So is that like a power phrase for you?
It's basically my objective when I'm out there. I'm a defensive player, and when the other team has the ball, they're trying to score on us, and if I go and I get the ball, that's like a home run for me. So that was something that anchored in for me, and I was able to say it to myself during the game, before the game, and also a couple other things that he suggested I do.
Being a hypnotherapist, it's stating that intention either out loud or to yourself, mm-hmm. and that's extremely powerful.
And then we double-binded him to any self-doubt that he would have. So
describe it. How do you double-bind
someone? So you would say anytime you have a thought that you can't do it or that you become fearful, it becomes harder to hold that thought in your body. And in fact, in its place, you have an increase of confidence. Now go ahead and try. The harder you try, the less able you are able to have that thought. And then there'll still be energy that might seep in, and it'll actually turn into confidence as opposed to, you know, go into the body as doubt.
You know, when I was talking to you, Todd, you asked us to bring in a little bit of our sports equipment. Can you show us how we use it in hypnosis?
Sure. What specifically would you like to work with?
First, I want to see you do something with David, because I want to make sure that I don't run around the room and start clucking like a chicken.
You don't have to worry about that. What we did with David, actually, with his gloves, is really give him a textural feel in his body. Because, you know, when we lace up our cleats and put on our gloves, a lot of times we just do it unconsciously. We're thinking about other things. I really wanted him to bring in all the senses. So I had him put on his gloves.
Now, was this in hypnosis? I didn't mean to.
This is before hypnosis. I had him put really feel what it's like to put the gloves on. Then he left them on. We went into hypnosis, and he was still in the way of feeling his gloves. And I brought a lot of anchoring into his actual hands, seeing the white light become his gloves. If he has a night game, tying the lights of the court into the light of his gloves so that anytime he saw the light, it reminded him of the strength in his hands. So we anchored like every aspect of his environment.
Show me how to anchor in a lacrosse. Is that called a lacrosse racket or a lacrosse bat?
A lacrosse stick.
Who knew?
Basically, he just had me put the gloves on. So
show me how to do it, Todd.
So as you're putting the gloves in, you're feeling the texture of the gloves in your hand, becoming more and more aware of your fingertips in each place, and you're feeling the white light of confidence all around your glove, so that your glove is actually made up of fibers of white light, giving you confidence and allowing you to get the ball. So we would do that both when he was just putting them on before state and then during hypnotherapy. We'd keep going back to remind him of getting the ball and how it's tied to the feeling of his hands and the gloves.
What was that like the very next time that you put on your gloves before a game?
I noticed it helps get me focused. He had me do a couple of things. He had me put the gloves on, but he also had me write down the saying as I was holding the stick. So I would hold this in one hand with the glove, and then I'd write down, get the ball, and I'd look at it and I'd take it in. And I just experienced myself getting focused, kind of put me in that zone.
The zone.
Yeah.
I love that. That's also a phrase that we hear in our common culture. What does being in the zone mean for you?
For me, it's being focused and able to perform at my best. So it wasn't like any miraculous things happened out there that I'd never experienced before, but it was more like I was solidly in my own zone. I was solidly performing at my best.
So what happened to the self-doubt and am I going to get the ball?
Yeah, that's
good. What happened to that?
I actually had an experience of that. I felt good most of the game. This was the first game that I played. I've played two since the treatments. One of them, I noticed that the thoughts came in.
Yes,
they surfaced.
And then?
I started second-guessing myself. And as soon as I noticed that I was doing it, they went away. It wasn't like it stayed with me and affected me. They went away and I was confident again and I was able to perform. And I think that was partly, I think you talked about that, how you programmed
that. Yeah, the double binding, that if they still came up and showed up, they didn't manifest in the body. They were still energy, but they moved more into your sense of confidence than doubt.
Okay, you convinced me. What can you show me? I have a tournament with this racket this Friday. What can you show me?
What is it that you want to achieve more of in your game?
I want to be fearless and charge the net. ABC. Always be moving. Let's see.
Closing. Forward.
Always be closing. That's it. Always be closing. ABC.
So you want to feel at
fearless.
At the net specifically? All right,
yeah.
So grab the racket as you would when you play the net. So you would do a one hand.
Yes.
And your hand would be out like that.
Yes.
So I want you to look at your hand and I want you to feel a sense of deep confidence. I want you to feel in your hand that racket and I want you to breathe deeply as you do it. And again, I want you to feel the racket in your hand. Look at your left hand. Look at your right hand. Feel the grip. And I want you to feel this deep sense of confidence, seeing the ball go off your racket into the other side of the court where they can't get it. And now close your eyes and do it one more time. Open your eyes and look at both hands again.
Okay. Does this come with a money back guarantee? I'm
Absolutely.
Going to win my tournament? Good. Now
You'll
let me
feel
get
more confident than that. I could give you that much.
Let me get my partner in here too. Always be closing. How did you know that?
I was in that play.
So I have to ask you, David, what would you say to someone who is having a little bit of mental block with any sport he or she has played? What would you recommend?
I would say, why not try hypnosis? It's another avenue. It's a tool that they could use and could be a really good reference for their performance.
And what would you say to someone about seeing Todd?
He's pretty well-rounded as a practitioner, especially if you have anything going on in the body, because a lot of times mentally or your thoughts or emotions can affect the body, and then you have discomfort or disease. He's able to help you with hands-on and then also work with programming the mind and suggesting the mind.
So we have the physical hands-on, we have the verbal and the suggestibility. That sounds pretty well-rounded to me. What do you see next for you, David?
I'd like to keep doing this and see how it progresses, and also maybe even use it in other areas of my life.
Have you used any of the tools you learned with Todd in any other area of your life besides lacrosse?
I did.
Tell us.
I'm an actor as well.
Really?
And I had something similar happen in an audition about a week ago where I was going through a process and I was getting redirection in an audition, and I started to notice some self-doubt, like, oh, I'm not going to be able to do this. And I actually said, get the ball, to myself. And the same thing happened. It was like, it went away, and I was confident again, and I was able to do whatever I needed to do. And I was able to listen and take in the information that they were giving me. So,
do you know why I love that? Because we use sports metaphors all the time, and get the ball is your sports metaphor. Because people also say, get back on the horse.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yeah.
So what a wonderful way to use it in every aspect of your life. Well, it appears that we're out of time for today. Everyone's going to want to know more about working with Todd Simon for sports performance or anything that might be holding you back. And you can reach Todd Simon at hmigrads.com. Now, if people don't live in the greater Los Angeles area, Todd, is there any other way that someone can have a session with you?
There is. I also do phone and Skype sessions as well.
Excellent. And that's Todd Simon on hmigrads.com. Well, it appears we have to take a short break. First, I want to thank Todd. I also want to thank David for coming in and being so candid with us about your experience. Please stay tuned, because when we come back, we're going to meet another HMI grad and learn more about how people are using hypnosis today. Stay tuned.